Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about IfElse. Assume you have a block of statements and you want to execute this block only when if a given condition is true. For example, you want to show the content only when the user is 18 plus. Whenever you require to check a condition before doing something, you can use an if statement. And the syntax of if is, you write if and then inside parentheses, you write the condition. For example, in this case, I want to print hello username only when if the first name is not null. So here I can write if first name is not equals to null. This means not equals to. And it will return true if both sides are not equal. So if our first name is not null, we will print the first name. Now if I run the code now, I will not get any output because our first name is null and the condition given is not true. And because the condition is not true, it will not come inside this if block and it will not call this println line. So that is why we are getting an empty output. But what if I put some value for the first name? So let's say I have written a value for the first name, that is Bilal. Now if I run the code now, I will get hello Bilal, because this time this condition is true. The first name is not null. And that is why we came inside and called the println function. And that's why we are getting the output. Now, if you need to write only one statement that is dependent on your if condition, you can write it like this. But what if you need to write multiple lines that are dependent on the if statement? For example, I just copied the same println line. Now I want to print hello first name two times. If I run the code now, I will get the desired output. We have hello Bilal two times, but this is not correct. I will show you. First, let's remove this line. Now both the lines should not be printed because the name is null this time. So let's run the code. We are getting hello null because the first name is null and only this println is dependent on the if statement. So after this println, anything we write is not dependent on the if statement. And it will execute all the lines after the first println call. The point is, what if you want to execute a block of code depending on a condition? So if you have multiple lines that you want to execute based on the condition, you need to group the lines inside curly braces like this. Now this whole block will be executed only when if this condition is true. And if this condition is not true, nothing will be printed because we have only the println statements inside this curly braces that is dependent on this condition. So if I put the first name as not null, that means we will assign a string. We will get the names printed four times as you can see here. But if I remove this line, nothing will be printed. You can see we are getting the empty output. Now what if you want to execute some other block of code when the condition is not true? To do this, you can use else. Now if this condition is true, we will execute this block of code. If this condition is not true, we will execute this block of code. Let me show you. I will write println here, and we can write anything here like hello name is null or whatever you want. Now if I run the code, I will get hello name is null, because this time this condition is not true and this block is executed because this condition was not true. So this is what we call as if else, and you can use it whenever you want to check a condition and execute something. For example, I told you if you want to check the age. So if the user's age is 18 plus, you can show some content. If not, you can show some message. For this, we can define an age, let's say 17, and we can check if age is greater than or equals to 18. So if the value of this age variable is 18 or more, we will print welcome friend, or you can write whatever you want. If the age is less than 18, we can print you are not allowed to see this. If I run the code now, you can see we are going inside the else and we are seeing this output. If I change the value of the age to 19, this line will be executed, as you can see here. So this is if else. So that's it for this video, friends. Thanks for watching.